to start my makeup, I usually start with like a moisturizer and a primer. And the moisturizer that I use is just like a drugstore brand. It's for sensitive skin, it's oil free. Sometimes my skin tends to be a little bit oily. And I actually put this on when I got out of the shower. So I can't necessarily put it on for you, but I just put it all over my face. And then the next thing I use is this NARS primer. I've used this for a little while now. This is only the first bottle I've ever used. But I just get literally like a tiny, tiny bit on my fingers. And then I just put this in my more like porous areas, I guess. It's like here and on my nose. And that just helps it get a little bit of a smoother look. Also, I do have a nose ring. And I like to take it out whenever I do my makeup, just because sometimes on my beauty blender it like pulls it and like falls out, or it like drags my makeup or something along those lines. Just doesn't give me like a clean look, I guess. And sometimes it just like cakes under it while I'm putting my makeup on. So I really like to remove it so that everything is just smooth. To start, I use this Clean Matte CoverGirl Liquid Foundation. This is the buff beige color. And then I use my beauty blender. For that, I use a concealer. And this is also CoverGirl. I really don't remember what this is, but it's just like a little bit lighter than my foundation. I mean, I'm not sure how the lighting is doing in here, but yeah. This is just a little bit lighter, and I put it under my eyes and a little bit on my nose, and then in these areas just where I would put my highlighter. And so to set all of the liquid foundation and concealer and everything, I use this CoverGirl Translucent Loose Setting Powder. Put down my I like to let my face kind of sit and bake a little bit, and while I'm waiting, I like to do my eyebrows and my eyes. So to do my eyebrows, this is a Smashbox palette. I got this for Christmas last year from my mom, and I absolutely love it. It's really kind of like the all-in-one palette, and a lot of people talk bad about them or have different views about them, but I obviously don't use this one like crazy. I use this for eyeliner, I use this for my eyebrows. Sometimes I use the wax, and this is like a contour area, and then this is just an eyeshadow stuff. But I use this color or this shade for my eyebrows. I do have blonde hair, but my roots come in a little bit darker, but I just like to use this to fill in my eyebrows. To go into my eyes, I like to put my liner on first, and then do my eyeshadow. Sometimes I do my eyeshadow and then my eyeliner. It really just depends on the pace I'm going, I guess. I just don't really have a preference of what order I do it in or anything, but I'm gonna start with my eyeliner, and I just use this brush, and like I said, I just go into this black on this palette, this same palette. So really when I travel, super nice, because I don't have to take a ton of stuff. I take this and I'm good with my eyeshadows, my eyebrows, and my eyeliner. So it's really nice. Okay, now that that is done, I go into my eyeshadow. And my husband got me this set of brushes. Actually, these plus two more came in like a whole pack. And they are like the It brushes for the Ulta brand of the brushes. But this is the All Over Shadow In. And I go into a light color to start with, just for like the base of everything. Next, I use this crease end for the crease, and I'm gonna go into a little bit of a darker color. I'm gonna kind of go into this dark brown a little bit and then go into this here. Just because I don't like it too dark, but I also like it to be dark enough to where you can actually like see it a defined line. So I just go a little bit into the dark and then I kind of go into the light. So something that a makeup artist told me one time, she told me that it's a lot easier to kind of go over a mistake rather than to wipe it off and try to redo it. I did get a little bit of eyeliner on my under eye, so I'm gonna try to tap that away. Okay, yeah. So it definitely helps rather than wiping it, because then you have these uneven lines and uneven spaces and you're just like, oh my gosh. So I'm just gonna continue with my eyeshadow. And for the lid, I really, for some reason, like to do shimmery stuff. I'm really not into the mattes of my actual eyelid. For some reason, I just like that pop, and I like light colors. So sometimes I use this pink here, just for a little bit of a more natural kind of look. It does have this matte, but it's a super light pink. So sometimes I'll do this and kind of mix them. Or I'll do this kind of gold shade here, and I like to make it a little bit darker and I'll just mix them and stuff. But I definitely like a shimmery eye, even for a basic look. It's just something that I'm into, so I don't know if it's weird or if most people do the shimmery for like special occasions and stuff like that, but I really do like it just every single day. Powder before I do my mascara. I kind of like my mascara to be like my finishing touch. But yeah, so I'm gonna go into my bronzer. Sometimes I can like contour my face using a little bit of these, but most of the time I just use this bronzer. And this is the butter bronzer, and this is actually the light color. I typically use just the regular, it's just bronzer. But they didn't have it, and I was like, I'll just use this light. I haven't tanned too much, and I'm already kind of white, so I was like, I'll just use this. Brushes, but I like to put it on and then just kind of fan it out. And this does have some highlighter in it, so sometimes I get a touch of this on just the edge of my brush like this, and I tap it. It's got a little bit there. Wow, I left a milk mustache. That's what Laura Lee calls it, a milk mustache with her highlighter on her kids. So I don't typically do a lip every single day. Sometimes I just do this gloss. This is actually from Victoria's Secret. It's just like a pink, like natural looking gloss. Just to give it a little bit of color, a little bit of pop. And then for my eyelashes, I do like to curl them most of the time. And I don't know if any of you know this, but if you heat it with a hairdryer and then curl it, it sometimes does a little bit better. Also, I just realized that the lighting on here puts like a super dark shadow when I'm looking down, because when I look at myself in the mirror here, it looks way better. So I'm definitely gonna take a picture at the very end so that you can see it. And then next for my mascara, this is just L'Oreal Paris, the Black is Black, their volume, just maximizing mascara, super simple. Daily look. This is kind of what I do every single day. It's nothing crazy, nothing fancy. I turn around a little bit so that you can see the, like, oh yeah, the natural lighting on it. So yeah, so that's it. Super simple in the morning. Sometimes it takes me like 10 minutes, sometimes it takes me 20. It really just depends on what I do. But yeah, that is all. And I'll link all the products that I can in the Like to Know It app under my selfie.